Shalom, Israel. I'm Yada Kai with the GMS Dallas camp. First off, I just want to give all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahushah, double honor to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and peace and blessing to the sincere Akim that's pushing the word in sincerity and truth. I just want to put a few scriptures up, just basically on the importance of just living in the spirit of faith in Yahushah, but at the same time, understanding that the laws that we can keep in this captivity, to the best ability, you keep those laws through faith. That's how you show your faith. Because you got a lot of guys in these Israelite camps basically slandering Great Millstone and saying that we basically teach that you're not supposed to keep the law and this, that, and the third, which we always emphasize that you are required to keep the law. But we have the understanding that we're in captivity and the things within the law we can't keep, you know, 100%. So that's why that sacrifice that Yahushua made was so important, man. We're saved, or we're justified by grace through Yahushua. But I just want to get a few precepts to just hopefully edify the brothers. I'll get this first account in St. Luke 13. I'll start at 14. It says, "And the ruler of the synagogue answered with indignation, because that Yahushua hath healed on the Sabbath day, and said unto the people, there are 6 days in which men ought to work. In them, therefore, come and be healed, and not on the Sabbath day. The Lord then answered him and said, Thou hypocrite, doeth not each one of you on the Sabbath loose his ox or his ass from the stall and lead him away to watering? Verse 16, and ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan hath bound, lo, these 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day? And when he had said these things, all his adversaries were ashamed, and all the people rejoiced for all the glorious things that were done by him." So Yahushua is just giving a clear example and basically tripping those wicked Pharisees up in things that they ain't really understand as far as the spirit is concerned, you know, of the law. You know, so if you have the opportunity to do good, especially to a brother on the Sabbath, man, that's the spirit outweighing the law. You know, because that the spirit trumps the law, because the law, the wages of sin is death, man. You know, the curse of the law is death, man, because Israel couldn't keep the law. But I'm gonna get that scripture later. I just want to go into a few other precepts to just clarify how it is important to keep the law, because you got a lot of niggas in other camps saying that Great Millstone, we don't teach to basically keep the law. When we always emphasize that you're supposed to keep the law, but we understand that we're in captivity and we can't keep the law 100%. That's why that sacrifice that Yahushua made was so important, because that's how we're able to have grace through faith to do the things to the best of our ability on this side, man, because we can't keep it the whole way, but we are expected to keep the law. And here's an example of Yahushua basically testifying on that. You can just bear with me, brothers. This is St. Matthew's 5:17. It says, "Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am come not to destroy, but to fulfill." So here's Yahushua, you know, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, saying he ain't come to destroy, but he came to fulfill. So yes, Israelite men, you know, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, we are expected to keep the law. But I got to get this scripture just to qualify something, just for basic understanding, you know, because you got niggas out there teaching false doctrines, man. Like the whole nation of Israel gonna somehow be justified on something that we can't keep. This is something we always gotta go into, because we're in our captivity right now. But the things that we can do in this setup, we do to the best of our ability. This is Judges chapter 5, verse 11. It says, "They that are delivered from the noise of archers in the places of drawing water." You know, in that place of drawing water, that represents the captivity that Israel is still in unto this day. It says, "There shall they rehearse the righteous acts of the Lord." You know, so right now we're rehearsing the righteous acts of the Lord. And in a rehearsal, you don't get every step 100% perfect. You know, you mess up, but you consistently, diligently practice it to the best of your ability. And that's what we're doing. It's all built on faith, man. in the spirit of Yahweh Shah, man. That's what's pushing everything. But at the same time, we know it's a balance. You can't have one without the other. Faith without works is dead. You're supposed to keep the law. We never teach any brother that they're not supposed to keep the law. So that's a lie for niggas out there who saying that, man. This is Romans 3 and 31. This is Paul, you know, speaking. It says, do we then make void the law through faith? The Most High forbid. Yea, we established the law. So we established the law, you know, when we basically keeping the law just as a testament to our faith. Because if you believe in something, man, then the requirements of it, if you have the ability to do them, you're going to do them. It's simple as that, man. It ain't really no need to get into some big philosophical breakdown about it, you know. And, you know, I'm just going to read a few scriptures just to further back that point up. Here's another one in, it said, this is Romans 6 and 15. It says, what then? Shall we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? The Most High forbid. So, you know, just because we have the liberty, you know, through the grace of Yahweh Shah, that don't mean we should just willfully go off, man. But we should be thankful that when we do go off, we have a chance to repent and sincerely not go in that way anymore if we have the ability to, man. You know? But just going on, because Israel, you know, the Most High had to make a new covenant with us through Yahweh Shah, man, because we couldn't keep the law perfectly. And I want to just, you know, get that real quick. That goes furthermore to just show just the importance of Yahweh Shah, you know, once again. This is Hebrews chapter 8, verse 7. I'll start at verse 6. It says, but now hath he obtained a more excellent ministry by how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises. For if that first covenant had been faultless, then should no place have been sought for the second. And that first is talking about the law of Moses, you know. It says, for finding fault with them, and it says for finding fault with them, meaning the people who couldn't keep it, the nation of Israel. It says, he said, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the hand of Egypt, because they continued not in my covenant, and I regarded them not, saith the Lord. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind, and I will write them in their hearts, and I will be to them a power, and they shall be to me a people. So that's just basically going into in the kingdom when Israel's going to have the righteousness of the law programmed within us, man. So we're not going to be able to go off anymore. But on this side, the things that we know and that we can do in this captivity, we just do to the best of our ability, all through faith and hope that the Most High, through his son Yahweh Shah, is going to show us mercy to be saved out of this destruction that's soon to come, you know. So I think it was one more I wanted to get. Yeah, I was going to go to Romans, the 8th chapter. That's another good one. Romans 8, and I'll start at 1, actually. It says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Yahweh Shah HaMashiach, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Yahweh Shah HaMashiach had made me free from the law of sin and death. So that sacrifice that Yahweh Shah did for us, man, which that sacrifice was done under the law, it basically allowed us to have this liberty and this grace, man, to where we're not subject to the curses for breaking the things that are written in the law, man. It says, for what the law could not do, it was weak through the flesh. The Most High, sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. So Yahweh Shah overcame the weight of sin in the law through that sacrifice, man. And the fact that he was a perfect sacrifice because he kept the law perfectly, man. So really, that's why we should just pay reverence that much more to Yahweh Shah, you know. So, you know, that was the point that I wanted to get, basically, you know. We're supposed to keep the law. You know, we don't want to get it twisted, but we want to, at the same time, always understand that everything's through faith in Yahweh Shah, because we can't keep the law perfectly. we are under grace right now to try to get this thing right and grow to the best of our ability, you know. So with that, you know, hopefully it was edifying to brothers. I want to just give all praises to Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, double honors to the apostles and the elders, and peace and blessings to the sincere brothers. Man up and shalom.